When you write a post, the Yoast SEO plugin will give you feedback on how to optimize your text. For this, we provide you with two scores, an SEO score and a readability score. In this video, we'll talk about the first of these scores, the SEO score. In the next video, we'll take a closer look at the readability score. The SEO score gives you a good indication of how SEO-proof your post is. It consists of various individual assessments, and each of these assessments will give you a feedback bullet, colored green, orange, or red. Together, they form the overall SEO score. The feedback from these checks will point you to the areas still in need of improvement. Now, let me run you through the various checks the plugin has. First of all, it's important that there is some substance to your post. That's why we check whether your text has a good length. Of course, the length of the text depends on the topic you're writing about. That being said, we advise a minimum of 300 words to have enough room to let your quality content shine. This minimum is raised to 900 words if you mark your article as cornerstone content. Cornerstone articles are lengthy articles that provide a lot of information about one broad topic. Usually, this topic is essential for your website's mission. For example, our own mission is SEO for everyone, so we create ultimate guides, like this one here, that provide free information on the major areas of SEO. The content on these pages should be flawless. Therefore, the requirements are generally stricter for articles marked as cornerstone content. When your article is cornerstone content, you get a red bullet in a lot of cases, where you still get an orange bullet if this were a regular article. And this is because we really want you to optimize these articles as well as you can. So you get a green score only if the content is absolutely top-notch. We've already told you that we run various checks related to your key phrase. Of course, we check whether you've set a key phrase in the first place. In addition, we check the length of your key phrase. We recommend a maximum of 4 relevant keywords, and by that we mean content words, not function words such as the or and for your focus key phrase. Longer key phrases make it harder to optimize your post, simply because you need to repeatedly use a large number of words close to each other, while still trying to create readable copy. It's important that this key phrase appears in a number of important locations in your text. These include the title, the first paragraph, the subheadings, and the image descriptions. All of these locations are important markers that give readers an idea what the text is about. Including your focus key phrase in these places will make sure that visitors of your site can immediately grasp the topic of your post. But you don't need to worry about remembering all of these spots for the key phrase. Yoast SEO has an assessment for each of them so that you'll always be reminded to include the key phrase in all key locations. In addition to checking where the key phrase is used, we also check how often it is used. To get the key phrase density, we calculate how many times the key phrase has been used in relation to the length of the text. Since the key phrase indicates what the text is about, it's natural that it should occur a number of times throughout the text. If that's not the case, that might be an indication that your article is straying away from the main focus. However, the key phrase also shouldn't be used too often. This makes your text sound unnatural to your readers, and Google also doesn't like pages that have been stuffed with keywords. So we have set a key phrase density margin. If you stay within this margin, you can be sure that your key phrase is neither mentioned too little nor too often. To take a step further, key phrase density can't be separated from key phrase distribution. Let me illustrate this with an example. If you use your key phrase 4 or 5 times in your first paragraph and then never again, your key phrase density is fine, but your key phrase distribution is not. Our key phrase distribution check, which is a premium feature by the way, will make sure you stay on topic throughout your text, which will increase your chance of ranking. Apart from looking at keyword usage within a post, we also make sure that you're using the right keywords across posts. It's crucial that you set a unique key phrase for each post that you write. After all, you don't want to compete with yourself in Google search results. That's why it's important that you don't optimize a post for a key phrase you've already used before. To avoid this, we have a handy reminder that will warn you if you set a keyword you've already used before. Let me quickly remind you that our premium plugin will also check for synonyms, related key phrases, and different word forms. These are taken into account for all keyword-related assessments that are relevant. Let's now turn to links. We'd like to make sure that your post contains at least one internal link. That's a link going to another page on your site. It should also contain at least one external link, which is a link going to a different website than your own. We do this in order to avoid dead ends. Users shouldn't land on a page, read your article, and then not be able to click through to new content. When adding an internal link to one of your other posts, we have a check that makes sure that link doesn't contain your focus key phrase. Because linking with your focus key phrase to another page would tell Google that this other page is important for that term. You don't want to do that again because you don't want to compete with yourself. Last but not least, the SEO analysis also gives feedback on all three elements of your snippet. It checks whether you've included your focus key phrase in both your SEO title, your URL, and your meta description. In addition, it checks whether the meta description has a good length. After all, you want to make sure that you've made use of all the space that's available. You want to describe the content of your page as best as you can, because you want to entice visitors to click through to your page. Finally, we'll let you know if the SEO title is too long to be fully displayed in the search results page. So, this was a quick rundown of our SEO analysis. I know, it's a lot of checks, but that's because the SEO analysis actually does analyze lots of different factors to make sure your content is optimized and ready to rank. Before we conclude this overview, I have one last important tip. Not every single bullet has to be green. What's actually important is that the overall score is green. Good luck!